Hello, who is this?
Listen, agency. I'm aware the last time the show was canceled, you lost everything. I know you're retired, but we need you now. You're the best director we've got.
I understand. I've got the script. Let's make it happen. All right, guys, we're gonna make the best show ever.
Hey, Ryan, I heard that Chloe Kim really wants to go to a school dance. What are the chances that she asked me to Sadie's?
How do I put this lightly? What's 0 times 0 minus 0?
0?
There you go.
Well, I'm Bradford.
And I'm Ryan.
And welcome to show 23.
Speaking of Sadie's, it's right around the corner. The dance will be held in the North Gym on March 9th from 8 to 11 p.m. Tickets start at $10 each, so be sure to grab one for you and your date, ladies.
There are over 240,000 DACA recipients in California alone. But after the Supreme Court's decision on Monday, what happens now? Adam has the answers.
On Monday, the Supreme Court refused to pick up the case regarding DACA, or Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals. Since the beginning of his presidential campaign, President Trump has wanted to end the Obama-era DACA program, which provides protection to the children of undocumented immigrants. The program was scheduled to terminate on March 5th, but on Monday, February 26th, the Supreme Court decided to decline a key case dealing with DACA, postponing it until sometime in the fall of 2018.
The court case will work itself through the courts to the Supreme Court. It's just going to take a little bit longer. Unless Congress can make a decision and pass a law that gives DACA certain rights, I don't see much hope for the program.
With the Supreme Court's final decision on hold for now, DACA recipients can take a sigh of relief and hope for the future. This has been Adam, and back to you guys in the studio.
Film Club's annual film festival is coming up on May 6th in the NPR from 3 to 4:30. For a small fee of $5, any video submission sent in by April 29th will have a chance of winning $50 or more. You can enter in multiple categories, but make sure that everything is school appropriate. Contact arcadiafilmclub@gmail.com for more information.
The recent Florida school shooting has caused a major debate on how to prevent similar tragedies from happening in the future. APN interviewed students and staff to get their opinions on this controversial issue.
The Florida school shooting has been controversial, sparking discussions on whether there should be better gun control laws or if teachers should carry firearms themselves.
From Kentucky to Washington to now Florida, school shootings have been devastating to students, parents, and their communities.
What else can we do to strengthen gun control laws? I mean, should they be given to 18-year-olds instead of 21-year-olds, which is the question that's happening right now? A lot of these people suffer from mental illness and these other problems. I mean, there should be ways that we should identify these people so they shouldn't pass a background check to begin with.
What happened in Florida was quite the anomaly due to the failure of both the FBI and the county police department in stopping the shooter. I would personally be in favor of further regulations such as more background checks. However, banning weapons in general is a poor idea.
Do you blame the NRA and to blame guns and put restrictions on guns? That is just too ignorant, and it's too hasty to do so. A restraint on an amendment is a restraint on a human right.
The truth of the matter is people kill people with guns. People kill more people faster with guns. But if what we're trying to do is minimize that, then we need to look at where the maximum damage is happening, and the maximum damage is happening with guns.
No matter what party, what anything you are, you can be affected by this because a death is a death, and we need to understand that this is an issue not just facing people in Florida, but all around in America, and this is an issue that our school and California needs to address too.
We shouldn't ignore the problems that can come to our own school's doorsteps. As students, teachers, and school administrators, we need to come together to prevent this from ever happening. This has been Ryan. Back to you guys in the studio.
If you want to get politically active and really make an impact in your community, you should join Arcadia Civic Youth Council. ACYC is an organization that promotes the understanding of Arcadia's history, community service, campaigning, and political activism. For membership information and applications, check out their website at www.arcadiayouthcouncil.org.
There are some rather unique things about this year's Oscars, and I'd be lying to you if I told you otherwise. Here's Trevor and Nick with the latest in entertainment, Oscars edition.
Hello again, Apaches, and welcome to the latest in entertainment. The Academy Awards have their ceremony every year, but this time, there are some notable records that Trevor and I are here to mention.
This year, the Oscars will be hosted by Jimmy Kimmel for the second year in a row. As for newly broken records, Meryl Streep, now with 21 nominations, broke her own record and is still the most nominated actress of all time.
Also broken is the record for the highest number of actors who appeared in more than one Best Picture nominee in a single year, with a total of 8.
Speaking of diversity, Octavia Spencer now ties with Viola Davis as the most nominated African-American actress in Oscar history, with 3 nominations in total. This is pretty significant for the Academy since there are usually very few awards for minorities each year.
We now see Rachel Morrison, who is the first woman to be nominated for an Oscar in Best Cinematography for her work on Mudbound. We will also get to see Kobe Bryant, who is the first NBA player to ever receive an Academy Award nomination for his work on Dear Basketball. As you can see, there are very many unique things about the Academy Awards this year. You can watch the Oscars on March 4th, 5 p.m., only on ABC.
Like watching this show? Do you like being in front of the camera? How about working behind the scenes? We need new recruits, and luckily for you, ABN is holding an informational meeting on March 9th in A102 during lunch. We hope to see you there.
Although we can't help you get a date to Sadie's, we can help you find what you want to do in college and beyond. March is Career Technology Education Month, and for the next couple of weeks, Jake will be highlighting different CTE classes, starting this week with sports med.
It's March. What does that mean? It's CTE month, and this week, we're highlighting sports med, taught by everyone's favorite Brit, Jack Sessions.
Sports medicine and medical and therapeutic principles are classes that introduce you into the world of athletic training. Athletic training is a subsection in the medical field that deals with specifically athletes and their injuries.
Anyone that's wanting to go into a medical profession, I would suggest to them, take this class. Any type of medical profession, whether it's a doctor, nursing, physical therapy, athletic training, the class, because it gives you a good overview of what sports medicine is. And we talk about fitness, nutrition, we tape ankles in the class, it's a very practical class.
What makes sports med special is that we have an amazing teacher, Jack Sessions, my hero, and also his assistant, Matt Nielsen, my second hero.
Sports Med is a great opportunity for anyone interested in the medical field. This has been Jake.
And Jack.
Back to you guys in the studio.
Hey, isn't it your birthday today?
Yeah.
Happy birthday, bro. But you know what that means, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Link Crew, to me, is a leadership organization that works to help freshmen become more comfortable in their environment, and they also help new students as well. And I know, like, my freshman year, Link Crew really helped me.
We make events for freshmen to participate at so they get more comfortable with each other in their class. We grow as a leader, so we come in as a junior or a senior and Link Crew morphs you into this, like, potential leader.
The cat, hungry again, crept into his bed. He would sleep, but oh, the voices in his head.
Flavortown! Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it.
We are all Arcadians in our heart, but do we actually know how Arcadia came to be? Here's the first installment of our History of Arcadia documentary.
Los Angeles County, Arcadia, California, with its blue skies and plentiful businesses, the city has become a bustling community. Its breathtaking scenery and devotion to nature defines Arcadia as a beautiful place. And to better appreciate its beauty, it is important to know how the city came to be. This is Arcadia, the garden of Southern California. Before Arcadia was a city, it was just open land, and for thousands of years, that land was inhabited by the Tongva Native Americans.
They were very peaceful tribes. Didn't cultivate much because they lived the land. They didn't have to fend for themselves much. They contributed very little to the land because they lived off of it.
As time went on, the Tongva's way of life would be interrupted by the arrival of Spanish missionaries and the establishment of Mission San Gabriel in 1771.
After the Spanish colonists came in the 1500s, they were known as the Gabrielino because they were all sent to Mission San Gabriel. Not all of the native people of California, obviously, but the native people of this region.
Afterwards, the Rancho period of Arcadia began with a man by the name of Hugo Reed. In 1845, he, along with his Tsongva wife and children, bought the Mexican land grant for Rancho Santa Anita. After ownership of the rancho passed from person to person, the grant eventually passed its way down to Elias Jackson Baldwin, better known by his nickname, Lucky Baldwin. After purchasing Rancho Santa Anita in 1845, he chose to make the area his home and began constructing buildings and cultivating the land.
Baldwin was the last owner of the rancho, and he bought it in 1875 for $200,000 from Newmark. And then he immediately became interested in developing it to its fullest.
And it was he who started this, who incorporated the city as a city with the Los Angeles County supervisors.
With the coming of the 1900s, Arcadia was starting to grow steadily after its incorporation in 1903. But despite the progress made towards the city itself, trouble showed itself in the form of worldwide depression and war. Stay tuned for part two, when we cover Arcadia from the 1900s to modern times.
Every Wednesday this month, Avid will be hosting a yoga class from 3:30 to 4:30. If you want to alleviate stress with a fun, relaxing workout, be sure to check out the next class on March 7th at the CTE building. Each class is $10 at the door, but you can pre-order the next four classes now for only $20. Please see Ms. Clipsing at C113 for more information.
The sun is shining.
And the flowers are blooming.
And spring sports has finally sprung. Let's get the spring spirit with
Apache Sports.
Happy spring, Apaches. You know what that means. It's a new season of Apache Sports. A little birdie just tweeted me about an interesting badminton scrimmage that happened on Monday. Our Apaches began their intense scrimmage both focused and persistent. Each and every pair displayed their impressive drives and outstanding footwork. But as the match escalated, Arcadia showed Diamond Bar who was boss, striking them with their cross-court and jump smash hits. It was a long, intense back-and-forth scrimmage, but it was all worthwhile when our Apaches won 12-9, beating Diamond Bar after 9 years.
We've been focusing a lot on our technical shots during our practices. We also have better players this year, so I think we'll do pretty good this season, and we're hoping to go to CIF this year.
As always, excellent job, Apaches, and see you at your next match. Now let's fly over to Caroline with boys volleyball and Naomi with boys tennis.
This week, boys volleyball set the competition on fire.
Arcadia started off the game rough in the first set with many missed opportunities to spike. Their team chemistry was lacking and the energy started off low. However, in the second set, Arcadia served it with spike after spike after spike. From then on, much like the ball, Arcadia's confidence on the court skyrocketed. Our Apaches took advantage of the Titans' slow reflexes and stayed close to the nets, leading us to score easy points. Arcadia came out on top with a final score of 3-1.
One of our goals should be to start off with a lot of energy, and then that'll get the ball rolling for us, and then we'll get a lot of momentum, and then that should carry us through.
What we did well was blocking, which San Marino did not have since they're not as tall as us.
Great job, boys. Good luck on your season.
This week, our varsity boys tennis team played against Glendale, and let's just say they caused a racket.
From the start of the match, Glendale was no competition for Arcadia. With Arcadia's strong aces and cross-court shots, the Cardinals were unable to return the ball. However, when Glendale was able to make contact, it resulted in many unforced errors, giving Arcadia free points, which they didn't even need. At the end of the match, Arcadia's grit and powerful hits had tired Glendale out, allowing Arcadia to win 14-0.
We did well on all aspects. Shout out to the boys varsity tennis team, by the way. And I think that while we play doubles,
yeah.
And I think
we really,
really
good
that,
chemistry. Yeah,
yeah, but I think that you can improve your serve like a lot.
And your volley.
Well, okay, yeah, okay, I'll give you that.
Great game, boys. Good luck on the rest of your season. This has been Naomi. Back to you guys in the studio.
Today, the backdrop contest will come to an end and one lucky person will walk away $50 richer. Thanks to all who submitted, but you can still submit by 11:59 if you choose to do so.
And congrats to last year's winner, William Chen and Mrs. Grubbs' English class for guessing her outro song, Claire de Lune. If you want to also have a chance to get a shout out, comment the title of our outro song with your name in the comment section down below.
And be sure to follow us on all our social media accounts listed down below. This has been Bradford.
And this has been Ryan.
See you at Sadie's Apaches.
I didn't hear what you were saying.
I live on all emotion, baby. I answer questions, never maybe. And I'm not kind if you betray me. So who the hell are you to save me? I never would have made.